各位，我哋。
Good afternoon, members. I call to order the meeting on members' interests. For today's agenda, actually, we would be having a discussion about a proposed amendment. The proposal is to align the deadlines for registration of election donations with the deadline for lodging election returns.And there are proposed amendments to the registration form on members' interests. So please take a look at paper CMI 40/15-16. I'd like to invite our secretary to brief us on the content of the paper. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. There was a questionnaire.And then 64 members, 93%, agreed to the alignment proposal. No one disagreed, and 5 members got no views. Just now, the secretary or the clerk told us that in accordance with our agreement made or reached at our last meeting, we have to lodge election returns.When we formally become LegCo members, and we need to, well, for the first time in relation to our declaration, 30 days, in the case of a by-election, 14 days will be given to lodge the, or to register the interests. Our proposal here is to align the deadlines. That is, whether there is an election or not, we are going to align the deadlines to make it run for 60 days. Currently, the requirement is to do so within 30 days and would like to make it no later than 60 days so as to.Align the deadlines with the deadlines under the relevant legislation. This will be more effective. In the course of our discussion, we have found that sometimes we might have forgotten to meet the final filing. That is, we beat the deadline of 30 days and later on we forgot the second deadline and there were complaints from citizens.I think it was in relation to Mr. James Toh. That's the case giving rise to this sort of exercise. We conducted a consultation by way of a questionnaire. As it has been reported, 64 members agreed, no one disagreed, and 5 members did not have any views. So I would like to seek your comments, and I would like to check with you whether you would like to...seek an amendment to Rule 83 in the Rules of Procedure. If you agree, then the proposal will be referred to the Committee on the Rules of Procedures, and then they'll have a discussion, and eventually we will go back to the full council for the amendment. Members, do you agree? Yes, Chen Yunhan. Yes, I do agree. This is because it was confusing.And it would easily give rise to misunderstanding. My question is, so does it mean that after an election, there will be 60 days for us to give the election returns to the chief electoral officer and to return the information to the LegCo? Is that correct, legal advisor? Yes. In other words, after the election results have been made, and within 60 days of that, there is a need to file the return. Does it mean that within 60 days of the gazetto notice? Yes, that's what we are proposing. Thank you. Would it be...counted from the gazetto notice? Yes, then it will be clear. After we have been elected as a LegCo member, Well, there will be some time before we actually take up our office. In fact, there won't be 60 days available in the interim. Say, for example, for this term, we are going to hold our election on the 4th of September, and then in October, we are going to take up our office. So, in other words, there won't be 60 days. So, if we keep the 30-day deadline, it won't be good. So, if members, if you all agree, then we are going to refer the matter to the CROP, and then the CROP, upon their agreement, will be referred to the House Committee. And then I, as the chair of the CMI, will move a motion at a council meeting. So, I have your agreement. Thank you. Then there is another proposal that is to make amendments to the form in relation to the registrable interest of members. Last time, we wondered whether there should be amendment to the registration form on members' interests. This is because there were complaints concerning shareholding interests in overseas companies. For the current form, there may be areas that are not clear enough, so maybe our clerk can explain why we would like to seek an amendment. Yes, if you would like to turn to Appendix 3, we have the proposed amendment to the form, and that's in relation to Category 3, that is shareholdings interest. For the title, we would like to change it to read beneficial interests in shares of companies or other bodies. This is to tie in with the definition in ROP 83.5H. That is, we would like to specify that it is beneficial interests. And then for subparagraph B, we'd like to talk about shares in local and overseas companies or bodies, and they have to be registered. And even if the company hasn't got any assets, doesn't carry on any business, or doesn't conduct any commercial activities, including shell companies, the interest has still to be declared. So we want to make it clear to members that all such interests have to be declared. Well, within our ROP, we are not seeking any changes. The only change is to be done through the form. We hope that in the form, we can make it clear so as to remind members that when they declare their interests, they should pay attention to this point. So we just want to clarify the form, and we are going to add local or overseas companies or bodies, including shell companies or bodies. So that's the background of the amendment proposed. Members, any comments or suggestions? Chen Yunhan, I don't have comments. Having heard what you have said, you're saying that we are not going to amend the ROP itself. The change will only be made to the form to make it clearer. Is that what you were trying to say? We are not amending the ROP. Yes, I know. Can you clarify? Mr. Chairman, Ms. Chen is right. Because the ROP does say what interests have to be declared, and there's the broad principle. As to the details, it will be sort of specified in the form subject to the approval of the President. In other words, when members are elected, we'll find it easier and clearer to know what has to be declared. Yes, to clarify for members. Ms. Chen, I think I've already answered your question. If we need to change the ROP, we have to do so at a council meeting. But then for the forms, subject to the agreement of the Committee on Rules of Procedure, the matter will be referred to the House Committee, and then the President will give approval, and that will be fine. We don't need to have any legislative exercise. Yes, allow me to supplement. The Chair is right to say that as to what has to be registered, it has been spelled out in the ROP. If there is to be changed, the ROP has to be changed. But then as to the details, for the registrable interest. We just want to add to the transparency, and we want to spell out the specific details so that it will be easier to fill out the form in accordance with the requirements concerning registration of interest. All right, Mr. Yik.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
I do not oppose to the principle, but then I wondered if we would like to visit Appendix 1. I'm afraid the wording may cause some confusion. It talks about notwithstanding the provisions in subrules 1 and 2. So you have subrules 1 and 2, and then you have 3. Can we not say that except the provisions in subrules 1 and 2, members may also furnish so and so forth under the Elections Corrupt and Illegal Conduct Ordinance? Would it facilitate easier comprehension? Legal advisor. For 83, 1 and 2, personal interests have to be declared. So it includes 83, 5, A to H. We want to single out what is contained in 2A, that is notwithstanding the provisions in other subrules. So 1 and 2 would include everything. Now you are singling out a particular point. Yes, that's in relation to election donations. And that's why I would like to draft it in this way. Well, I think my version will make it easier to understand. Other than the provisions in subrules 1 and 2, members must also do the following things. As you know, that the legal language is difficult to understand. What I try to do is to make it easier for laymen to comprehend. That is, other than the provisions, or in addition to the provisions in subrules 1 and 2, the particulars under subrule 5D1 shall be furnished. Maybe legal advisor can take a second look. SG. If you read the English version, it says notwithstanding the provisions. So it is right to render it into 准管 in Chinese. But then if we say 除, then it will be other than the provisions. And then the meaning will be different.
Perhaps we hear from the legal advisor. So other than and notwithstanding, I agree with the SG. It says other than the provisions in subrules 1 and 2, it means that you have to furnish returns in relation to election donation as well. So there may be a conflict because you have to at the same time furnish the same under cap 554. So you may wonder which way you should do it, under which one. Well, I make this proposal because I get confused after reading it. So now you say that subrules 1 and 2 includes all the registrable interests, and in relation to elections, that it is under subrule 5D1. If I'm a newcomer, I will not know what you mean. Well, I am an incumbent legislator. I still don't understand what you mean. We will take into account what members said and we'll find a way to better express it. So you agree with the amendments? If you all agree with it, we will make arrangements as soon as possible. To make recommendations for it to be considered. I want to ask members, in relation to the amendment to the form, should we seek views of all members via circular or via questionnaires? I'm a member of this committee. I do think that everything is clear. However, when it comes to other members, it would be better to seek their views by questionnaire. In that case, we will do it by questionnaire. And if a majority of members agree to that, we will take the second step and we will submit it to the president for his decision. Any other business? There is no other business. Meeting adjourned. Thank you.